You may have, do you have crazy people like that here? They walk up to you and say, have you thought about where you'll spend eternity? You know, you can't buy a stick of gum in America without some guy saying, have you thought about where you'll spend eternity? And so they wanted me to go out and do that. And I was 15 years old and I didn't know shit. And yet I was telling people where they were going to spend eternity. It was kind of funny, except when people disagreed with me, because usually they had some very good logic that disproved what I was saying. And then I would have to agree with them, and then my church people would be mad at me because I'm not supposed to agree with the sinners. It was complicated. So they gave me this special guy in the church. He was very good at winning souls to the Lord. And he could go to an atheist convention and come back with 25 or 30 people ready to accept Jesus. And he was so successful that they sent him to the penitentiary, the big prison down in Jacksonville, or Tallahassee. It's called Rayford Penitentiary, and it's a bad prison. And I guess he had this kind of confidence that the guards thought that they could trust him with a serial killer. So they let him try to preach Jesus to this serial killer. And he was in there for an hour, and when he came out, he was never quite the same. He had like a nervous twitch, and he never won souls to Jesus again after that. I never did figure out what was said to him in that room, so me being an artist and all, I decided I would make up a story about it, and I put it in this song right here. It's called Prisoner's Dilemma.
That's just what the good Lord made me. You can claim.